A pleasant evening to everyone. I'm Altaura Tuskin, doing my second year BDS in Savita Dental College. I'm here to present my e-poster on analysis of anthropometric measurement of mandible for age and sex determination using orthopantomogram, a systematic review. You may wonder, why have I taken anthropometric measurement of mandible to determine the age and sex? Well, the mandible, it is the largest bone in human skull. It is appreciably viewed in orthopantomogram. And based on the evidences, there are varied anthropometric measurements such as mental index, bonial angle, condyle length, etc. All these help in determination of age and sex. So the main aim of the systematic review is to analyze anthropometric measurement of mandible in determination of age and gender. Well, let's go into the methodology. How have I conducted the systematic review and what were the guidelines followed? Well, the guidelines followed was the PRISNA guidelines. It stands like the preferred reporting item of systematic review and meta-analysis. Those guidelines were followed, and the database was taken for PubMed ranging from 2010 to 2020. And then the mesh terms which were being taken into consideration were morphometry of the mandible, morphology of the mandible, orthopantomogram, sex determination, mandibular measurements. Then we followed with our of the risk of bias. Risk of bias, you may wonder, what is it? It's nothing but the risk of the systematic review. How much the result is true, to the extent to which it acts to be the true result which has been obtained. And depending upon the sample size, the way the methodology has been put forward, we could give a qualitative analysis of the particular study. So using a robust tool, PODAS 2, I had done a risk of bias of the articles which were being considered in the study. Well, the data screening process was also done. Total records were being identified to about 62, and the records selected out of it with title screening was about 58. The reason for exclusion is that the eligibility criteria was not met. And then the records selected for with full abstract as well as the full text was nearly about 40. And then the full text record was selected with out of the inclusion criteria was about 4. You may wonder, why have I excluded so many? The main thing is many of the articles showed for odontometric measurements, but we were in consideration with anthropometric measurement of the mandible alone. So the four main articles which were being chosen was first the study done by Saigram MG et al. In 2020, in which he had considered the radiograph for about 955 with the sample size. And then the comparison was done with that of the Saudi and non-Saudi participant and male and female. And the age group were about 20 to 40 years and 41 to 60 years and above 60. And then the outcome variables were considered in a study was that the mental index, the panoramic mandibular index, and then antigonial index. And then the methodology which he took was the previous from the previous study of Houston et al. And then that of the Dahlberg et al. And then the result concluded that the mental index and antigonial index was higher in males compared to that of the females. And then the panoramic mandibular index, which was only differentiated the Saudi and non-Saudi participant, but that is not considered as a parameter in this systematic review. And then we have the second study, that is the Shah PH et al. 2020, in which they have taken the radiograph for about 300. Okay, so in which the age range was compared to about 10 to 90, and then 20 to 29, 30 to 39, 40 to 49, 50 to 59, and 60 to 69, and males and females records were being compared. And then the outcome variables were being taken as the gonial angle, ramus height in different age group, and then bigonial width. Okay, so the method used in the inner study was that Kodak 8000C digital panoramic thing he used, and then cephalometric imaging system he used. And then the result and conclusion he gave was the right and left gonial angle was higher in females compared to males. And then bigonial width and then ramus height was higher in males compared to females. And then the ramus height was seen to increasing as the age was increasing. Okay, and the third study, which was taken into consideration, was done by Curtis G. et al. In 2018. So the panoramic radiograph was being taken into account was 442, in which females between 18 to 34 years and aged 35 or more were being taken into consideration, and males of the similar age. Then the outcome variables which were being taken was the mandibular canal measurement, mandibular teeth, roots, and then mental foramen position. So they followed the methodology using AutoCAD 2010 software. And the result and conclusion which came in to consideration was the mental foramen located in between the first and second premolar apices in younger individuals and immediately below the inferior second premolar in older individuals. And then the mandibular canal did not show any significant difference with that of the sex and age, so we don't consider it. And then we have the fourth study, which was considered in the current systematic review, is that Sairam V et al. In 2018. It was the panoramic radiograph, where we've taken about 150, and age groups about 50 years of age and below 25 years of age they considered, and then males and females were being compared. So the outcome variables were about gonial angle, ramus length, condylar length, ramus notch depth, and then cortical bone thickness. So in that, the methodology was same, similar like that of the Shah et al., where they followed Kodak 8000 digital panoramic. And then the result and conclusion showed, except gonial angle, others were all higher in males. Gonial angle was higher in female, but other parameters was higher in males. So depending upon this results, we had concluded that the anthropometric measurement of mandibles, such as bigonial width, gonial angle, ramus height, and mental index, helps in determining age and sex with the use of panoramic radiograph. Except gonial angle, all other measurements were decreased in female. And then the mental index was significantly higher for about 41 to 60 years. So mental index can be a main parameter for determining the age. And then the gonial angle can be helpful in determining the sex. And I want to even put a point over the risk of bias, where the articles which were being chosen, they had nearly 50% low risk of bias and 50% high risk of bias. Basically, the articles which were of third and fourth article had a little risk of bias, because the there was no proper methodology, and then there was no proper radiographic differentiation how many males and females were being taken. So depending upon that, they had higher risk of bias compared to the first two studies. So thank you so much for giving me the opportunity.